Time has passed in Asturias from the dawn of mankind. The oldest fossils found in the region do not even belong to our species. They are from the Neanderthals that dwelt in the cave of El Cidrón in Polonia 49,000 years ago. Other important prehistoric fossil remains linked to the Homo sapiens and its artistic expressions are those of the Tito Busillo cave in Riva de Sella. They are considered one of the best examples of art from the High Paleolithic in the world. Around 9,500 years before our time, a local epipaleolithic culture begins to flourish, the so-called Asturiense. Their main remains are located near the coast, in caves or shelters near the sea. During the revolutionary Neolithic period, the human groups that roam around Asturias began to develop their techniques for agriculture and livestock breeding. There are many marks that give testimony to this groundbreaking process, such as the burial mounds in Mount Areo in Carreño. This is also the time when metals begin to be used. During the Copper, Bronze and Iron Ages, humanity settles around the castros, a type of population that will live on for many centuries and which will be slowly transformed with the arrival of the way of life of the Romans. The way castro culture was abandoned and the ways in which the lifestyle brought from Rome was adopted seemed to be much stronger than what was previously thought. The most recent archaeological finds estimate that the inhabitants of the region before the arrival of the Romans were not as reluctant to adopt new customs, nor the invaders were so strange to the lifestyle that they found once they had crossed the Cantabrian range. It is also believed that the Asturianization of the social and cultural organization brought by the empire has a lot to do with the appearance of the Kingdom of Asturias later on. One of the most important episodes of the history of Asturias took place after the fall of the Visigoth Kingdom and the occupation of the region by the Arabs. In the 8th century, and after the mythic Battle of Covadonga, the Kingdom of Asturias breaks into the political landscape of the peninsula by bearing the responsibility of the process known as the Reconquista. To boost the importance of the region during this process, the different Asturian monarchs promoted an artistic activity of architecture and goldsmithing known today as the Asturian pre-Romanesque art. With the death of Alfonso III in 911 and the subsequent division of the kingdom among his heirs, Asturias begins to lose its relevance in favor of the other kingdoms of the peninsula. Between the 16th and 17th centuries, one of the most important cultural events in the region was the creation of the University of Oviedo. Nearing the middle of the 18th century, the Cadastre of Ensenada shows a population in Asturias of 200,000 people, of which around 90% work in agriculture. The Asturian city of Gijón is the cradle of one of the most notorious figures of the Spanish Illustration, Gaspar Melchor de Jovellanos. Starting during the second half of the 19th century, a high number of Asturians begin to leave the region towards America, in a process that would become one of the most telling signs of the recent history of the region, emigration. One of the other constants of the history of Asturias is also forged during these times. The creation and promotion of a strong economic sector linked to the extraction of coal and the steel industry. The turmoil of humanity as a whole, and Spain in particular during the 20th century, left its mark in the Principality. For example, in the October Revolution of 1934, or the Spanish Civil War, which had in this region one of its bloodiest scenarios. Around the mid-20th century, Franco's regime started to slightly open the economy, which leads to the creation of two public industries in the region, Encidesa, dealing with steel, and shortly afterwards, Nosa, which exploited mines. The coming of democracy in Spain coincides with the global crisis of the 1970s. Asturias begins a period of economic problems and reconversion of its main productive sectors. With the entrance of Spain in 1986 into the European Economic Community, Asturias needs to radically redesign its economic approach in the fields of agriculture, mining, the dairy industry, steelworks, fishing, and naval. The structural funds contributed to lessen the effects of this transformational process. Asturias faces the future with the same opportunities and uncertainties as other regions of Spain and the world. We live in a time of abrupt and global changes, and each community in the world is facing the challenge of finding their best arguments to contribute them to the common tale of history.